in this. Hey, this nigga Cat Williams didn't set it off. You know what I mean? He set the bitch off, man. He went on Club Shay Shay. Mm-hmm. And he had a few things to say about a couple people. You know, Steve Harvey, Kevin Hart. You know what I mean? Mm-hmm. Chris Tucker. Fucking said the entertainer, Ricky Smiley.
Faison.
He called him a Faison fat liar. What do you think about Cat Williams setting off the ether bomb so early in the year? What you mean?
He basically came at the whole world. I mean, that was crazy. I mean, yeah, that was the hell of a way to start the year.
27 million views in 3 days.
Yeah, I think that shit like up to 30 something by now. They're going crazy. Yeah, I mean, Cat always, you know, he always his shock value is up there. Like, Cat always had crazy shock value. And he a comedian, so he's doing his job. He did exactly what he wanted everybody to do.
Because I think he got a special coming out.
Yeah. Exactly. He's about to be on tour. But, you know what I mean? Like,
and the nigga got a Kevin Hart baby mom on tour with him.
Oh, yeah?
Did you see that?
No, I ain't see
she
that.
She ain't shit for that. Oh, shit. She's a dirty motherfucker. Well, people in the comments like, he ain't put her on.
He got enough bread, so he could put her on. And Cat really be on some real shit. He really do be putting motherfuckers on. Like, he be, like, when he popping, like, he tour with other motherfuckers who not
He said he on tour with people who ain't funnier than him. Yeah. That's what he said.
I mean, yeah, that's bullshit. But
That's how he feel.
But, no, I mean, he do roll with some funny motherfuckers, though. Like, I can say that. Like, he don't be, he ain't just putting motherfuckers on because he know him. Like,
but what you think about like, that? Is that the ultimate, like, is he wrong or is she wrong or is it what it is?
I mean, about Kevin Hart baby mom? Yeah. I mean, no, shit, if she getting a check from her, get a check. Like, who gives a fuck? Like, nobody. Like, if he not taking her on tour and giving her a check.
I mean, he giving her a check, for sure. That's his baby mom, but he not taking her on tour,
probably not trying to give her no opportunities through him, which I can understand, so. You know what I mean?
But you going to go with the op?
Trying to do that and get the opportunity? Oh,
the
op
that just went over there to Unc and said, blah.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, because at the end of the day, like, it's Cat Williams, so you got to take what he say with a grain of salt at the end of the day. Like, it was a lot. Don't get it fucked up. I ain't saying he was bullshitting with everything. It was some truth in there. Like, some shit in there I can actually agree with. But all that other shit he was talking about, like, it's just for shock value. He don't really. That's Cat Williams, dog. Come on, man. You know what I mean? So I'm not taking
So you don't feel like he did a Pac Faith Evans type thing?
No, it's troll. It's hit him up. I don't want to say he a troll, but it's shock value.
She on tour.
He was trolling, you know what I mean? But it's for shock value. He knew what he was doing. You know what I mean? Like, he said Kevin Hart is a fucking plant. Like, the industry planted him there. Like, I see what you saying, but, like, no. You know what I mean? I see what you trying to say, and I understand what you mean, because Hollywood has backed him and gave him money, but that don't mean he a plant. Like, so, like, it's like, you, like.
He probably play nice. Yeah, like, I mean, a lot of stuff that motherfuckers say no to.
He made it big as a comedian. Now he a plant. So what if you would have made it big as a comedian?
Now
nigga,
you a plant. I mean, he did make it big.
You know what I mean, but
supposedly, what he said in that interview,
he don't think he was Kevin Hart big.
I guess. Well, in the interview, he said a lot of the movies that was sitting on his table that they asked him if they took something out, he'd do. Kevin Hart ended up doing, and he did the thing that he was asking him to take out.
Wait.
So basically, I got a movie on my desk, right? That you gave me. You put something in there that I feel like it compromised my manhood or compromised black men's manhood, basically. And I say, look, if you take that out, I'm good with it, and you won't get back to me. And next thing I know, Kevin Hart in it, and he doing the very thing that I asked you to take out. That's what was happening. Basically, that's what he said.
Right. And I'm not saying there's no
So he said Kevin Hart basically did the suspect shit he wasn't willing to
and
do.
And I'm not saying it's
what movie is this? What did he do?
I don't know.
Because I seen Kevin Hart shit. Yeah, I ain't never seen no suspect.
Niggas
shit.
Say Kevin Hart wore a dress and all this other shit.
You talking about on SNL?
I don't know.
He did that shit on SNL.
Yeah, I don't know. But whatever. Like, it's like motherfuckers find shit. You know what I mean? Motherfuckers.
Hold up, but you said he wore a dress. What do that mean?
That's That's what niggas say. Like, that's what Cat Williams' whole thing is. Like, they not going to demasculize me in the movie and all that
But is it about that, or is he saying that if you wear a dress, then you're in some type of society? Which one is he saying?
I don't know. I don't know.
Because Brandon T. Jackson, after he did Big Mama's House 2 or whatever, that, we ain't seen that nigga since. So it don't work for everybody.
Yeah,
it's niggas who did dresses it didn't work for.
So
you know what I mean? Like, how far do that wear a dress thing go? Because in that case, every drag queen would be popular.
I mean,
him getting money because they all men who wear dresses.
But that's the thing.
What they voluntarily do?
Exactly.
So you got to be a person.
Niggas don't want to do it. Them niggas getting paid to do it. Like, it's a difference. They wouldn't do that shit on a regular. Like, but the whole thing is, it's like motherfuckers. They like Cat Williams want to play both sides of the field. Like, you want to be that boy, but still talk shit about other motherfuckers. Like, it's cool to talk shit about people and,
if you don't plan on fucking with
him and all that. I mean, he don't plan on fucking with him, but I'm just saying, just to get the clout to go on tour. Like, I don't think anybody came at him that warranted him to do it.
Like, what I mean, he did?
Yeah, I don't think. Like, I didn't.
Well,
I
mean, who's to say that? If you in his shoes, and like he said,
he
the work he put in for these certain parts, and somebody's got the lesser part in the movie, say, oh yeah, that was supposed to be my part. You know what I mean? He really had me come in and do it, so I don't even know how he ended up getting that. And you had came up with the wardrobe, you came up with the hair, you came up with the voice, you got your teeth knocked out, didn't get them fixed for to keep the head apart. Told him what cars to get. Actually went and got Bishop Don Juan to be in the movie because you wanted to get a fake actor pen. Like, did work for that. And now he feels some type of way. How can you say he can't?
Yeah, no, I definitely understand that. Yeah, I definitely understand feeling some type
of way.
Like,
nigga, you act like,
I feel that.
Say you auditioned for the part, nigga. Don't say
no, I feel that. But I'm just saying, all the extra shit he did, like, that shit wasn't warranted for that. Like, he still
said you the entertainer stole the joke. And I seen that before. And I didn't put two and two together.
He did say that. He was like, and that was his. No, I ain't
seen it. We got to do a review on the live. And show the two jokes.
Yeah.
Cat Williams did it on BET Comic View.
Yeah, he said that. And he said he was running Comic View.
He was calling it like a big car. It was about a big car. But then on the Kings of Comedy, when Seth did it, he just changed the Cadillac or whatever to a spaceship. And he did it the same exact joint, the same movements and everything that Cat Williams was doing.
Yeah.
So, yeah.
Damn.
So, that was the thing with Cedric. Then the shit with Steve Harvey. I guess when Steve Harvey was coming at him at some point in time, and he was saying basically, like, Steve Harvey quit doing comedy after he made fun of his man unit. So he's like, you got everybody thinking you got the crispiest hairline of all time, nigga, and it's a man unit.
Yeah, he definitely is talking shit about that.
I used to say that too, because when I didn't know it was a man piece, I used to be like, yo, why his line
Steve
always
Harvey's
crispy,
line
yo?
Everybody
I know
Harvey
got the little
line.
Hair that come over their hairline a little bit when their hair start going back. No, not Steve Harvey. Nigga crispy. Crispy cream.
That's why.
It wasn't real. It was really bald, and whatever the main unit stopped, that's where the hair stopped.
Yeah.
That's crazy.
That's what I look like.
How when did you find out his hair wasn't real? The box.
Cat Williams fucking interview.
Oh, so you just did. You just,
Cat Williams interview.
Oh, well, guess
nigga.
What? The cat out the bag. Let the cat out the bag.
The cat definitely let the cat out the bag, man.
I'm
God
pretty sure it's since you said that, then I'm pretty sure it's a lot of other people who didn't know
that
shit was fake.
I thought that shit was real. I thought he just got a baldy recently. Like, fuck it. You know what I mean? Last 20 years, like, fuck it. Let me start rocking this baldy now. Like, that's crazy.
I saw some pictures that showed, like, the back of his head and everything. He had the bald spot in the middle and the back and all that.
Damn.
Yeah. He got rid of that shit quick. As soon as he got the money, main unit.
Yo, that's crazy.
I'm not going to be on my TV show with a fucking George Jefferson.
Yeah, I mean, but Cat probably feel like everybody deserted him, left him out to dry when motherfuckers were saying he was a drug addict and, you know what I mean, he crazy.
He was like, man, I never did smoke.
Like, I'm pretty sure ain't nobody check on him. Ain't nobody, you know what I mean, probably only a couple few motherfuckers who really is homies.
No, people probably checked on him, just not the people that he don't like.
Yeah, you know what I mean? So he probably still got a grudge because he definitely mentioned something like that. But I just think it was just Like, come on, Cat. But hey, if you trying to get promotion for your tour and your project, listen, man, job well done.
So what you think he was? All right, so would you? All right, we gonna go down the line with the people who Cat was talking about.
Mm-hmm.
All right, try not to slam too hard. Mm-hmm. Kevin Hart, guilty or not guilty?
What you mean? As far as what though?
Huh?
As far as what?
As being the industry plant.
Oh yeah,
not guilty.
Yeah, not guilty.
Come on, you ain't hit the
exactly. Dog, not guilty. Not guilty.
All right, not guilty. Says you the entertainer, stealing the joke. Guilty.
Guilty. Yeah, definitely guilty. Definitely guilty.
Ricky Smiley. How can
really
I line
be
that
Money
up?
Mike.
That would be true or not true?
Yeah, right. That would be true.
I want guilty or not. Yeah. All right. Is he guilty of telling a lie about playing the pimp in the role?
Guilty. Guilty. Absolutely guilty. There
now,
Steve Harvey got a fake hairline.
Guilty. Guilty, but that's not the right one, though. And he don't have one now.
Right, he don't have one now.
He was guilty of having a man unit. And that's guilty. But we're going to say, with Steve Harvey, we're going to say, was Steve Harvey guilty of hating on Bernie Mac because he was the funniest out of the Kings of Comedy? And guilty.
Yeah, you gotta finish that.
I give him that.
Hell yeah.
Because he said a lot of things about that, too. Shout out to Club Shay Shay. Shout out to Cat Williams, you know what I'm saying? Yeah. I know you're only really doing this, like he said, because your project is coming out. Yeah, but, man. You know what I mean?
That's good.
It was masterful.
Right.
You lined up all the dominoes, and then you knocked them down.
He's a master of ceremonies with that. He killed that joint straight up. And he ain't come at nobody. He ain't come at Chappelle. I can tell you that much.
You just leave alone.
Yeah, he straight said nothing about Dave Chappelle. Yeah, like he ain't say nothing about Martin. You know what I mean? Certain motherfuckers he ain't say nothing about. Mm-hmm. So you got to start wondering, like, I don't know.
No, it's just, if he don't got no problem with him, I wouldn't expect him to bring him up. Yeah. You know what I mean? I'm not going to bring him up if I fuck with him.
I don't know why he brought up Chris Tucker. I don't know, like
he brought up Chris Tucker crazy, because he said he didn't want to do no more Fridays and shit because he didn't want to be the weed smoker person. He didn't want to get stuck in that role.
Mm-hmm.
But everybody knew that already. Right, but now he be coming out saying he didn't want to do it. So fuck out of here.
Yeah.
He did it because he wanted more money. That's crazy. What it is, man. He doing this thing. Shout out to Cat Williams, man. I hope it work out for you.
Stop snitching, though. Definitely snitch if he did that. Yeah,
I just want to say it's fucked up that Tory Hart, you still going to use Kevin Hart name.
Tory.
And you going to go with the ops.
And go with the Izzops.
You tripping. Yeah, you tripping. I would cut you off. If he giving you any type of money for anything, I would cut you off.
Yeah, nah.
I would cut you off. Yeah. Let Cat pay your rent. You know what I mean? Because I know he was doing something smooth like that because that's his kid's mom. So I know he was paying her rent somewhere, even if she's still living in North Philly.
Support.
He paying the rent.
Child support. She don't live in no North
the kids,
Philly.
I think the kids.
She might not live in North Philly.
No, she probably live in North or K&A or something like that. He ain't giving her that much. He probably getting like $500 a month. Kevin Hart, man, fuck out of here now. Bitch, go move down to K&A. You ain't getting shit else.
She getting something nice.
She gonna be down there with the motherfucking fiends leaning like a kickstand.
She getting enough money where she ain't even gotta be there. She could be on tour with Cat.
No, yeah, from where Kev was getting her. Guess what? Your line of credit is gone.
So she doing something.
She ain't doing shit.
She ain't doing.
She's Kevin Hart baby mom.
Yeah, exactly.
Money for nothing.
So she doing something exactly. So
doing what?
She did something.
Yeah, she gave up pussy.
She had the baby to the right nigga.
Years ago.
Some bitch have a baby by motherfucking
the right one.
By Rodney on the fries. You know what I mean? She can't get shit out of that nigga.
Yeah.
So she did something. She ain't doing shit, but she did something. at one point.
I mean, she a comedian, so.
You know what I mean? She
getting, yo, she I got like how everybody's saying Kevin Hart wrote, I mean, she wrote all Kevin Hart early shit now.
Come on, man.
Like, yo, come on, dog.
Just like Safari wrote all Nicki Minaj shit.
Right, like, y'all always try to find a
yo,
way.
Yo, as soon as Nicki Minaj and Safari broke up, niggas like, oh,
Safari
shit, dog.
Wrote it.
He was right on that shit. Yo, man, shut up.
I ain't gonna lie. All his raps right after that sound just like it, though. Yeah, breathe it, breathe it. Nah, that ain't it, yo. That ain't it. He looked salty
it
as
wasn't
shit.
It.
He looked salty it as shit it. When Charlamagne was like, nah, that ain't it.
That nigga spit his heart out.
Yeah.
And everybody just was looking like, what is going on?
Like, but he sounds just like Nicki when he was
yeah,
rapping.
Yeah, that's
him.
The problem, nigga.
But that's what I'm saying. That's why everybody was feeling like maybe he had wrote this shit.
No.
Now if he didn't write it and he was trying to prove a point by rapping like her, that's fucked up. You ain't shit for that.
It's
if you
diabolical.
That. Yeah, like, look, I'm going to rap like you so they can think that shit. Yeah.
You's a diabolical ass nigga, Safari. You know damn well that ain't how you rap for real. You
knowing him, he wrote that shit just like that because he knew that Charlamagne was going to say some funny
that
shit.
Is hilarious.
But yeah, man, that's enough on that topic, man. We talked a little bit about that. Yeah, you know I mean, so, Cat man, Williams got no smash. Cat. And he went on the Ghetto Boys podcast, talked a little more in
Ghetto
depth.
Ghetto Boys.
But yeah, I mean, you want to see any more of that, check that out, man. We ain't going to go too much longer on that one.
Yeah, this is a crazy ass killer. You know what I'm saying? This is Hoover from Silicon Valley. This is Dwayne from Dodgeball. I'm on the Buck Bandit podcast. Chris Williams. Check it out.
Turn me up a little bit. Turn me up a little bit.